Jeremiah being pissed, and I believe Josh might back that car. We got another motherfucker pulling there today. Today's gonna be a big day. I got a quote from Robert Greene, 13 strategies more. The wealth vanishes. The latest game is accepted because passe, the allies are certain. But if your mind is armed with the art of war, there is no power that can take that away. I like that a whole lot. That goes back to staying in love with the process, knowing your values and your end goals, your grand strategy in the book. But yeah, that goes into a lot to that. That helps a lot. I got another one right here from, I forgot how to pronounce that. But it says, moment whatever may happen, you let your mind be free. Stay centered while accepting whatever you are doing. This is the ultimate. It says, moment whatever happens, let your mind be free. Stay centered by accepting whatever happens to you.
An idea can't change. And Schultz taught me the major problem is lack of an idea, not a problem. At first, I didn't have any money. I said to Mr. Schultz, I don't have any money. He said, that's not a problem. Now, see, up until then, I always thought it was. Right? I was confused. He said, no, the problem is lack of an idea on how to create money and wealth. It isn't lack of money, it's lack of ideas. So if you get the ideas, see, you can change anything. Now, to get ideas, you need a constant study of finding out. Now, Schultz also said, when you find out something that works, put the information in your journal. Don't use your head for a filing cabinet. Put it in your journal so that you can do the next best thing. Repetition, repetition, repetition. Go over it. And if you repeat it, go over it, sure enough, someday, some mysterious day, the idea takes root, starts to grow, and shows up. Here's the first one. You may not be able to do all you find out. I understand that. You may not be able to do all you find out, but you should find out all you can do. See, you don't want to wind up at the end of your life and discover that you've lived only 1/10 of it. And the other 9/10 went down the drain. Not for lack of opportunity, for lack of information. So that's number one, find out how things work. Now here's the best human virtue for finding out. Might as well forget it, you don't have a prayer. Excellent advice. You gotta be like children. Four ways, in my opinion, to be like a child. Number one is curiosity. Number two is excitement. Get excited like a child over your ability to make yourself do anything for change. Third is faith. Have faith like a child. Adults are too skeptical. And fourth is trust. Trust is a childish virtue, but the rewards are incredible. So be like a child. Now, if you're curious, let me give you three ways to find out how to develop your personality. Did you know there's books on that? And people don't read them, how would you explain that? And they can read. Did you know that hundreds of successful people have written their stories in books and they wrote down how they did it, and people don't read it? How would you explain that? The guy's busy, I guess. You know, you get tied up. The guy says, well, yeah, you work where I work, but the time you struggle home, you're clever, you can pick them up. Watch it all. If a guy's making $10,000 a month, I'd watch how he walks. Maybe that's it. Copy his funny little walk. Somebody says, well, that's kind of a silly walk. Say, it's $10,000. I haven't got the money yet, but I got the walk. It's bound to start somewhere. What I ask you tonight is to be unusual and be a good observer of what's going on. You can pick up ideas that can change your life starting tomorrow. Just be a more careful observer. Now remember, there's two ways to see. One is called sight, see with your eyes. The other one is called insight, see with your eyes. Don't miss anything. Now, we've lingered a little bit long on number one here for personal development. Find out how things work, but it's so very important finding out. And I've given you three ways to find out. Now here's the second step to personal development. Okay, number one was find out how things work. Here's number two, go to work. You must now take action on what you found out. In doing business around the world, we call it game plan. Put together your game plan. One of the major things we teach on the weekend seminars, game plans. How to game plan your office. See, that'll change everything. Massive action is called the cure-all. If you're gonna make calls, make a few thousand. If you're gonna make contacts, make a few thousand. If you're gonna knock on doors, knock on a few thousand. See, that'll change everything. Here's the language of the poor. I'll try it a time or two and see what happens. It's the way poor people talk. The guy says, well, I'll give it 30 days. 30 days. You could guess his bank balance. You've got to have a better game.
Because all this talk of step-aside money and all that he went, I don't care about money. I want my rematch.
Yeah.
He was offered. He was getting offered like 10 million, 15 million to move out of the way and all that. And he said, no chance.
Yeah.
I want my rematch. I want my fight. If you enjoy something and you're good at it, you'll get paid for it. So I enjoy boxing. I was good at it and I've been paid for it. But it's not the be all and end all of anything. I could end up in the council flat at any time. Don't worry about that. So would it change me as a person? No. Do I need a mansion and a Rolls Royce? I don't. I've got them, but I don't need them. But it doesn't make of you as a man. A man is what you are in here. What come from nothing. You know, it's never been about money. I'm not a money person. I don't care. I don't care what I've got. It's never been about money to me. I know a lot of people with money, big money, but none of them are happy. Not one of them. If you're a millionaire and you're horrible, I don't want to know you.
A few people who actually live their childhood dream as an adult,
yeah,
and get paid to do it, so doing a good old job, really. Just did what I wanted to do. Like Frank Sinatra said, I did it my way. I'm always active, I'm always fit.
Yeah.
So I'm not one of these fighters anymore that will go off and take tons of time out and not keep active. I'm always in the gym every day.
And the one thing that I've always prided myself on is never getting involved in anybody else's business.
I have no really interest in all that glitz and glam. I never have been, never will be. I'm not interested in fame or being a celebrity. Do you know what I want to do? I want to be left alone.
Yeah.
All I can do is my job. Which is to
get out of the stone.
So if you look at Tiger Woods today, natural talent, from 2 year old he was knocking balls all over. But he's got his dark side, he's got his demons, all of them.
Yeah,
I think everybody who's like a real natural talented, great at what they do, they all have demons. Muhammad Ali was the greatest of that era. I don't believe in matching fighters from different eras because it's just not fair on the individual, because you can only be the best of your time and you can't cross different eras and different times. All of these stars, Muhammad Ali, Mike Tyson, they've all had their struggles along the way, whether it's been with mental health, whether it's been with drink or other stuff, political or whatever, they've all had their own.
Hey, real good shit, man. Purple lean in the cup, baby. Yeah. Ride music right here, playboy. Yeah. Got snipers on set, got guns on deck, got spots on deck, for the clock on deck, for the streets I love hot. Three crazy with numbers, Glock in my hand, obliterated the drum, my situation is bumpers, kosher, Sosa, drop top pusher, I fuck Oprah, make a nigga broad neck, open like a cobra, pops in the sofa, blue green rover, hold up, bless me nigga just like a Nazi, face me a box, Colorado, Rocky, Poppy, hoes be calling me out, on the beat, ducking from the bullets, I'm coming to do a robbery. Charge these hoes, I need payments. 38 lens, killing them with the great tip. Lyrically, I'm fragrant. Got spots on deck, got spots on deck, for the clock on deck, for the streets I run. Bring the whole thing down, make your bitch chain round, young girl, and accent. Me and all the deals on set now, riding the trucks on the hits. Jail hole, got a closet full of Gucci and Chanel toes, nigga, true religion. Nigga play with this ain't try to jewel me, I'ma kill him, that's my motherfucking true religion. While I'm feeling like a monster, smoking like a rasta, big booty bitch, I'ma fuck her like a porn star. Then get high and go and talk to my own star.
Come on, nigga, what's going on? Three crazy way, you know what I mean?
Three crazy!
Fuck you saying, me? Hey! Three crack.
Stay tuned!
Nigga on my head, I'm like a beagle on my hunt. Dove by the pound with the eagle on the front. Troll, he killed him. He was on Simpson. Sitting in the region, smoking on the blunt. All hard. Bitch, I got 25 scores. Blow a nigga head all 25 yards. I'ma go nuts if you test me a little. I'ma leave one of y'all fuck nigga crippled. Shoot him in the nuts, in the guts, in the liver. Leave a nigga head with the dust.
Just another guy that came to check it, that came to wreck it. No disrespect, but mommy, that's correct, cause pushing them jeans just got my mind hectic. I can see that you're feeling my passion. Is it cause I'm crashing? Or is it this cash that's just way too reckless? Or is it this necklace? Wait, let me get to wrap myself with this. Get on a knee. I just want a quickie. No bite marks, no scratches, and no hickeys. If you can give me that, mommy, come give me me.
I don't wanna be loved, I don't wanna be loved.
I just want a quick fix up in your mix, miss. No quickie, no bite marks, no scratches, and no hickeys. If you can give with that, mommy, come give with me.
I don't wanna be loved, I don't wanna be loved.
I just want a quick fix up in your mix, miss. Send me your wish list, I have you addicted. So mommy, come hit this.
I don't wanna be loved.
Warm welcome to the motherfucking Nation Riders.
Music up this motherfucker. So we can say this
no,
shit.
No, she ain't coming. We just gonna stop right here.
Shit. Hey, everybody, I don't give a fuck.
Everybody's clap their hands.
I don't even want it to.
Everybody, come on.
Biggest Marsh.
I don't give a fuck. Yo. I do this shit just off of some hand claps. We rock this motherfucker.
If you will change, everything will change for you. You don't have to change what's outside. All you have to change is what's inside. To have more, you simply have to become more. Then he said, don't wish it was easier. Wish you were better. Don't wish for less problems. Wish for more skill. Start working on yourself. You'd have said, well, Jim Rohn's a hard worker. You say, well, how come he's got pennies in his pocket, nothing in the bank, and behind on his promises? Well, I was a hard worker, but I was working hard on my job, not on myself. I'm telling you, if you'll learn that simple little principle and start the process today, latest tomorrow, I'll give you tonight to think about. And start this whole process of personal development, work on yourself, make yourself more valuable to the marketplace, I'm telling you. You can so dynamically change your income by the person. Success is not something you pursue, chase, run after. Success is something you develop, something you become, you attract success. So the whole key to unlock all the treasures, whether it's economic treasures or spiritual treasures, financial, social, personal, every way you can possibly think of, is by your own personal development. Then he added one more, which is so important, and it's probably worth the price of the seminar. Here it is. Right? He said, doesn't the company pay 2, 3, 4, 5 times this amount to other people? I said, well, yes. He said, well, then this is not all the company pays. It's all the pay. And if you qualified, wouldn't your income grow 2, 3, 4, 5 times? So he said, you don't have to work on the company. You have to work. See, that was the beginning of what he called the phrase personal. I told him things cost too much. He said, no, you can't afford them. I thought, well, that's a new concept. I hadn't thought about it. You know, we put some of the valuable things on the high shelf, so you can't get to them until you qualify. Nobody taught me that in high school. Nobody taught me that. I went to 1 year of college. Nobody taught me. Profits are better than wages. Wages make you a living. Profits make you a fortune. And how could you work on both a living and a fortune? I said, well, you could start part-time working on your fortune while you're working full-time on your living. I thought, wow. Now he said, it's fun to get up in the morning. Not just getting up, go to work to pay the rent. Get up to go to work to make a fortune. First to make a living for my family. Then what could I do to change my income and multiply it by 2, by 3, by 5, by 10, and then multiply it by 10 again? What could I do? And he started giving me the disciplines and the process of learning the skills to change my life. This was an extraordinary man. Those were extraordinary times for me. Life changing in every manner that you can imagine. But very simple ABC concept. Here's what I learned. Not to search for the exotic until you've discovered the basic. And those basic
philosophies that he shared with me during that time were life.
You're ready to change. Let me give you 3 steps to start life change that can change your life, your personality, your lifestyle. Everything can change. Here's the steps. Number one, find out how things work. The first key to doing better is find out. To change your life, really, you need ideas. There isn't anything an idea can't change. And Schultz taught me the major problem is lack of an idea, not a problem. At first, I didn't have any money. I said to Mr. Schultz, I don't have any money. He said, that's not a problem. Now, see, up until then, I always thought it was. Right? I was confused. Great word. If you wish to be successful, study success. If you wish to be happy, study happiness. If you wish to be wealthy, study wealth. Don't leave it to chance. Make it a study. Some people just go through the day with their fingers crossed. See, that won't do it. You've got to study the things that can change your economic, social, spiritual, personal life. Now, if you're curious, let me give you 3 ways to find out how to change anything. Any life direction, any dimension. Here's 3 ways to find out how to change anything. Number one is to read. Become a good reader. All of the successful people I know and work with around the world, they're all good readers. Curiosity drives them to read. They gotta know. They just read, 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 read. Become a good reader. Now that's my opinion. Listen to the other lecturers and listen to me and make up your own mind. Don't be a follower, be a student.